We are now in the tech corner, and our man DK Cyber David Jedu is here to talk to us about romance scams. What's that all about? Have you ever been a victim? Do you know anybody who has fallen victim? It's in the news this week because of the misadventures of Hajja for Real, who's been extradited from UK to the USA to go face charges. Could land her in a lot of jail time. But hey, what are online romance scams? Let's get to the bottom of that with our man in the corner. Boss, what happened?
Great.
Let's start by defining what is a romance scam.
Michael, thank you very much. And good morning to our viewers. Mm-hmm. So when you say romance scam, you're looking at how people fake their online identity to emotionally, you know, win people trust and extort money from them.
It's as simple as that.
Yeah. So we are talking about how, you know, you can fall in love online. Mm-hmm. You know, people do a lot of things online, of which falling in love online, having emotional feeling for someone online. Mm-hmm. But this time around, you are not dealing with the right person. The person has faked his or her online identity. Mm-hmm. Then he's using someone. So we talk about identity thefts here. He's using someone's image to talk to you. Then you fall in love for that image. Then they start the scam process, or they start the bailout processes, of which the bailout processes comes in so many forms, so many types, and so many disguised ways that you might not really known about.
Okay, so tell me, so who are the people who are most likely to fall victim to scams like this?
All right, so yes, then if you asked me this question some years back, I would say the white men, the old white men, like the old white pension men, women in abroad, them, they were much victim, or they were victims of these things. But today, hey, no, we here, we are all victims. Anyone who uses internet, anyone who comes online is a victim. Why am I saying this? Because today, they are not even, you know, now the European countries, or let's say the US, they have really advanced the education system. So even when you have, let's say, someone you're chatting abroad, and the person is supposed to even pay something to you, the process of payment, there are so many education for that person that the person might really look for some red signs to stop paying you. Mm. So now they are focusing on us. Now this is what happened. Even if you don't have anything, they start to become friends with you, start all those, their conversation around emotions with you. And now they pretend to come in the picture to help you, right? So you are, okay, if I'm a guy and I have fallen in love with a white lady abroad, my vision or my hope in the future is that she's likely going to pick me abroad. So this where...
Why can't she come to Ghana?
You know, yes, either she comes here, we get married, then we go to abroad. So that's some of the vision, or that's some of the hope of our young guys, you know. But this time around, it won't happen that way. They rather would find a way to scam you through so many methods. And one of the common methods it uses, they would try is, okay, they want to bless you with gadgets. So you see the list. An iPhone 13, iPhone 14, laptops, and they will say they have hidden some money. They won't tell you that from the start. They will tell you that all the VAT, everything has been paid. So they are shipping it to your country of origin. So say Ghana. So the packages come to Ghana here, and a local number will contact you, say that they are going to deliver the packages to you, but the delivery or some clearance were not paid. So you have to pay for it. So then you get back to the person who claims to be your lover online, then the person will tell you that, you know what, I didn't know your rates at that time, so you know what I did? I put some dollars in a rubber, kept it in one of the files that are coming, so when it comes, you can go pay the CDs. When it comes, then you take out the dollar. So you see, it started online with romance. So now, when you make payments, some pay 300, 400, 500, and they never get the gadget, they never get anything.
Somebody tried it on me.
Okay, yeah. You have experience, but yeah, yours might not be romance.
Well, yeah, it wasn't. They said it was about some funeral and some auntie, something.
Okay,
I cursed the person in Efe. Very powerful. Have you heard Efe curses before?
I
sound like drum language. Tell me more.
Goodness. Yeah. Yes, so that is what is happening today. So, yes, the focus is not just about the white ladies, the old white men and women, but now us, every internet user, we are all victims of these things.
Okay, so what are some of the sites that we should be wary of, how can we protect ourselves?
All right, so fantastic. So one of the sites, or most sites, should be social platforms and those dating platforms. We have them a lot. I don't want to mention them, but we have them a lot. So this is one platform I really like. It's called the romancescams.org.
Okay.
Right. So here, you come here to read a lot about these things. You come here to get much knowledge about these things. So yes, before you talk to someone online about any emotions or love, there are some certain things you need to find about the person. We always say that sometimes verify the profile picture they are using. To do that, we have so many apps you can use. One of them is to use what we call the Tiny Eye, right? So the person's profile picture used, you just upload the profile here. It does an online search for you. It filters in to bring you who the person is. Probably the person will say, oh, I'm in the States and I'm that, but to your surprise, it might be even those kind of porn stars and other people that they use their image to.
So they take somebody's picture and then pass it off as their own.
Yes, so that's all about these scams. So they try to fake an identity, right?
So if I put the picture here, it will tell me who it is.
Filters in. So if like maybe I've asked your name, you say your name is Thomas, right? It's Thomas, we also know any name. And you put it in here, you upload a picture. If you have a picture, you can just upload it. Mm-hmm. It does an online search for you. I have not downloaded any picture yet. It just it will do an online search for you. Then it brings you relative images. So if that image has been found online before, so you go and read even blog posts about them, and you now know that what that particular platform was saying that they were,
it's not. So Tin Eye. Okay.
Yeah. So Tin Eye. We can also use what Google too has this for us. We go to images.google.com.
Yeah.
Same could do the same thing for you. You search in Google, run through their platforms to find where those images are, and you're likely to find some info on that.
All right.
So yes, so that's it. So we can come to this romancescams.org.
So you can find all kind of things. You can see criminal records, photos, email addresses, phone numbers, social profiles, home addresses, relatives and associates, sex offenders register.
Yeah.
Okay, so the person could be a sex offender.
Yes.
All right, okay.
So yes, so these are some of the platforms that these things take place. Especially, they start with you on maybe Facebook Messenger. They take you to Google Hangout and they will tell you that, okay, let's start vibing. And that is where the thing. So you have Facebook, you have Instagram there. And now, this is very important for me. I think it's hard time that we need to really talk about these things. See, this thing is affecting us internationally. It's really downgrading us on the international market. You know, this week or last week, Nigeria was in a good trend of breaking Guinness Book of Records, whatever.
The Bassey woman.
Yes, and we were in the trend about romance scams.
Yes.
Look at it. So you see, in the whole West Africa, you know, we need to claim our name. We are doing so good, but some bad guys are really affecting us. See, Nigeria tops the chart in terms of scam rate. And
Ghana
is number two.
And the people who are fighting a war are number three and four. So you have Russia, Ukraine. Russia is number three, man.
Yes.
Ukraine is number four.
Yes.
And then Malaysia is number five. So this is the top five. Yes. Okay. The machine is even angry. It's just gone off. It's back. All right.
So we are talking about romance scams operate from. So we are talking about romance scams. And if you look at the chart for Africa, Ghana is still second. And this one, I think they even... So having Russia, Ukraine here, that means that it's for the world.
Yeah, this is the world chart, and Nigeria is number one, Ghana is number two.
Yes.
Oh!
You see, and the point is that's why I'm saying that it's blocking a lot of chance. Now, look at it. If you just want to apply for scholarship, because of these things, they have to scrutinize you. If you want to go do something abroad, because of these bad guys, and you know what? What happened is, 10 years down the line, when internet started with, Ghana here, when it came here, you have something called Sakawa then, right? Nigeria has something we call the Prince scam.
Yes.
Now, when it comes to Ghana here, when Sakawa started, the guys thought they were so smart, so they started using what we call the VPN. Thinking that it encrypts their conversations, it reroutes their location. Forgetting that, you see, now we have gone so much advanced where everything is being recorded. Right, everything. Now, if you bring me your phone, forensics can review whatever you did on the phone from day one, whether you factory reset it or whatever, it brings it back. Now, I just wanted to show you something here. When you go here, even Google, you search myactivity.google.com, it brings back to whatever you are doing online.
So be careful.
So be careful.
That's
people
all.
Think that they are doing these things and they are hiding. You are not hiding. You are not hiding. You know what happened with Aja Flory? They are saying that they are really diving into it to see all the people who helped her.
Yeah, and they've been tracking her since 2013.
Yes, so look at it.
Ten years.
10 years now.
Yeah.
And it's likely that you're going to have a lot of people in the picture, and that's going to put our name still on an international map.
We may go to number one.
I pray it won't happen, Cal.
What a league table, man.
Yeah, so when, you know, was it Assemblies of God or Pentecostal chat that they just had? Maybe when they are praying, they should add that to the prayer topic.
So that
Ghana will really...
Yeah, because I don't like that league table, man. Nigeria number one, Ghana number two, Russia number three, Ukraine number four. That one is really shocking me, man. They are fighting, but they are still doing this, man.
Yeah, so, you know, yes, they have they have them in boom levels.
Yeah.
Yes, in boom level, So we have some chat about these, you know. So, yes, we can go here to really check. And let me come here to see. So these are some of the ways, you know, when it happened. You know, Ghana here, we can report to Ghana National Cybersecurity Authority. So we come here.
Yeah.
We come to the Ghana National Cybersecurity Authority to report. You go to report an incident, right? Assuming you're a victim of this, you go there, you report an incident to the local here. But if the incident happened, let's say, online and you are dealing with international, yes, you can still report here. But you also do what? You also go to what?
Scamalytics.
Yes, report scammers. So you do your report here and they pick it there. In case you are a victim of these things, yes.
And you know, Ghana, we like doing videos. When something happens, then they go and do videos. Listen, when the thing happens to you, go and report.
Yes.
Yeah,
yes.
It's easier.
Yes.
They scam you and you come with a video. How does that help us? You know, go to Scamalytics.
Yeah. So in Ghana here, we should be using
CSA.gov.gh.
So we report. I think they take it out there.
Okay.
I think you come here to Scam Advisor to would advise you. So you come to this platform. It's a good platform that I really like using. So Scam Advisor, you go to Romance Scams. Let's close that. Yes, let's close that. We have some reports.
So this is focusing on the people who are using... Okay, so it's checking to see if the connection is secure. Yeah. Then it pushes... Okay, romantic dating scams.
Yes. So you have a lot of in-depth knowledge on these here, right? So that at least you could also find... So they have a lot on here for you to read. So you come here, you see there are some categories, online shopping scam, crypto, all these things are scams in that...
The scams are plenty.
There are a lot, Calf.
Online shopping, phishing and identity, other scams, hoaxes and frauds, cryptocurrency, fake online stores. Betting scams, adult dating scams, everything there. Yeah. Scam hell.
Calf.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I think that it's hard time that we need to do the good thing. You see, the fact is that people think that they hide behind things so they could perpetrate their fraudulent activity and nothing gets done. I'm telling you, when it comes to the internet, there's nothing hidden. Irrespective of the highest VPN you are using, use CyberGhost, use whatever, they will still find you because they can just take your encrypted data from the ISP, send it to, with a court order, all those even companies providing the VPN for anonymity, they exist. They could go and take their backtrack and you could be caught. So don't think that, you know, you've read about small articles, so it is scam, so it is hide behind. You know, at the end of the day, you are really affecting others. Because right now, the way the scam rate is high, it's affecting a lot of things we do international market.
Yep. Ghana can't, we're not on PayPal and things like that.
Yes, because of that. Because of the scamming activity, that's why they block
us on PayPal.
And Nigeria too.
Yeah.
So you see, we have
So I found out that Ghana is number three in terms of internet activity, the whole world. Number three. You know, so we're really into this stuff. So quickly, just before we go, common tactics used by scammers. They will ask you for money, either in the form of actual funds or products, as you're talking about, or services. They will go to any length to manipulate you.
Yeah.
They may impersonate a soldier. They may impersonate oil rig workers because they know that money days and where. So perform that background search and make sure that you protect yourself. Oh, what a league table. I don't like this league table.
Yeah.
Common countries where romance scammers operate from. Nigeria, Ghana.
I think we should be projecting this more so that people would now...
Yeah.
Our attention comes on this because these things are really affecting us.
Indeed.
They're really affecting us.
All right, man. How do people reach you, David?
Yeah, right. From the Cyber Zone. Now it's going to be Cyber One Defense. Okay. Next month, we are rebranding. So we are launching Cyber One Defense in Abilinkpe big time.
Yeah.
And we have some things like... We are now doing free workshop, free community service for adults.
Okay.
And we are also teaching the kids on internet safety for free.
Okay.
You come sit in the lab. An advanced ultramodern, all the words you could use, lab, come to Abilinkpe.
And then you're done.
And you are done, Rekal.
So you're rebranding from the Cyber Zone to what?
Cyber One Defense Communication.
That's why you're dressed like a general.
Oh, yes, you know what I mean, Cal.
I salute you, brother. Thank you so much. That's a man in terms of cyber issues, DK Cyber. My name is Kafu. It's 6 minutes to 7 o'clock.